how do I plan on standing out next year? Just being real creative, just letting people see what's in my head. My main goal right now is just trying to make sure I let people, you know, envision the words that I speak. You know, the raps that I push out there, I want to be able to relay the message to where you can get it. You know what I'm saying? You can get the message easy. You don't have to really go in depth about, you know, listen too hard to understand what I'm saying. So, you know, next year I plan on standing out just by, you know, being real creative, keeping it real with my audience, and just, you know, being true to myself and, you know, not worried about other people and what they're doing and how they're moving in the music and things like that. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, just be in tune. That's what we got for next year. You know, just watch. You know, you're going to see all the creative juices come out. You know what I'm saying? If I could compare myself to any other artist, I mean, it's hard. That's a hard question, because I feel like, you know, I represent Soul Entertainment. So, you know, Soul Entertainment, we feel as a family that we different. We're different. You know, we're not the same as everybody else. We're not the same as the regular rappers and the people you hear. And, you know, we want to be different. We come from, we go past the atmosphere, past the stratosphere. You know what I mean? We in the galaxy. It's not the same, you know what I mean? We're not the same as the people from Earth, you know? So, you know, I feel like I'm in a lane of my own, you know? I don't really want to compare myself to people, you know, because I really try not to, because, you know, that messes up my originality, you know? Me being original in who I am and who I stand for and things like that. So, you know, when it comes to that, I feel like I'm in a lane of my own. I'm starting my own lane. I want to be in the class of my own. I don't want to be like anybody else. I don't want to sound like anybody else. I want to sound like who I am. You know, and that's Lamaj. What I think listeners can get out my music, I want to be able to be real, you know, and to be honest and to be, you know, truthful. I have to start letting people, you know, into my personal space, you know, and I'm not a real person of letting people in my personal space, you know what I'm saying? And where I come from, you know, you got sharks, you know, people who want to get in your business and things like that, but, you know, I just want them to get where I come from, where I'm at, and where I'm trying to go, you know what I'm saying? Because I have million-dollar visions, but, you know, I'm still in a 100,000 range, 20,000, less than $20,000 range, you know what I'm saying, poverty level, you know what I'm saying, so, you know, I feel like I want people to know where I come from, where I'm at, and where I'm trying to go, you know, and I want them to know that, you know, life is hard, and you gotta watch out for certain individuals, and be able to pay attention to things, and pay attention to people and situations, and know that, you know, we are the rulers of our own destiny. You know, we are the people that put rocks in our own path. You know what I'm saying? Right, you know what I mean? We the people that we put rocks in our own path, blocks in our own path. Things that happen to us in life is because these are the things we chose to do. This is the options and that we chose to take. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, as a human beings, we have to be responsible and be able to see, you know, the actions that we make and the consequences behind them and be able to accept that. You know what I'm saying? So I want to give a real message. I want to talk about everything, you know, every day, from my life to the people that I've met in my life to, you know, the things I've been through to the things I'm not going to let happen to the things that will happen to, you know, just everything, man. I want to, and, you know, I'm working hard. I'm practicing. I'm writing. I'm trying to build my work, you know, my portfolio, my skills, and all that. So, you know, I just want to relay a message that, you know, no matter where you come from, you can make it, you know. Because once I put the music out and you start to really hear where I come from, you see where I come from, the things I've been through, if I can make it, if I can go through it, and I can still be here and smiling and feel like life is okay and things are fine, and you know, then anybody could make it. You know what I mean? Anybody could make it. Because I lost my moms. I lost my pops. My pops was shot to death. My moms was stabbed to death. You know what I'm saying? I was like, my pops died. I was 3 months old. My mom died when I was 12. She got killed. You know what I'm saying? She got stabbed to death. So, you know, I've been through a lot. You know what I mean? And all the things that I've been through, you know, nobody picking up the pieces, family not being around. You know what I mean? So, you know, they feel like they don't have to. But anyway, you know, it's just like, you know, if I could go through it and be where I'm at today and come as far as I've come by myself, you know what I'm saying? When the average person would have felt, if I could do it, anybody could do it. And that's what I want to relay through my messages. That's what I want. I say, when I was young, you know what I'm saying? This coffee, yeah. When I was young, you know, I was always a dancer and entertainer. Dancing, singing, Michael Jackson. You know, I'm half Jamaican. My grandmother take me to her little yard parties and had me dancing on my head. And I'm a grandson, that's my grandson. And everybody like, Jew, that's your grandson. You know, and then on my American side, I'll be doing the Michael Jackson dancing and stuff like that. So, you know, I always liked music growing up and you know, the times that I grew up in. And, I mean, I don't know, I've always been a businessman. You know what I mean? I've always been a business guy. You know, I went to school for business administration, then I went and majored in business administration, hotel technology, you know, and growing up, you know, I always wanted toys, you know what I mean, like video games, but I was so bad, I was always on punishment, so I couldn't get certain things. I was always in my room, you know what I mean? That affects you because you get older and you don't mind being alone and you mess up relationships and stuff like that. But when I was young, you know, they'd be like, come on, Mike, you want to go shopping? I'd be like, yeah. I want to go shopping. And they'd be like, come on, we going to Barnes and Noble's. And, you know, as a kid, nobody don't care about getting no books. You know what I mean? So, you know, they'd take me to the book section. And I grew up a lot being in Barnes and Noble's. You know what I'm saying? Like, reading books, self-improvement books, trying to better my life and my situation. Because, you know, nobody had to do or teach me. You know, but the little messages that I did take in from my family, you know, the good, you know, I applied it, you know. So I took my street smarts and my book smarts, and I put that together, and, you know, here I am today. So, you know, just loving the music, loving the business, being able to give something and receive something in turn, and be able to give something and have people be like, man, yo, good looks, bro, yo, yo, I feel like that, you know. I'm going through the same thing, you know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? So, you know, if I could do it in real life without rhyming and, you know, I could do it on a paper, you know? So my goal is being able to, you know, transfer my real life into the music, take it and put it on paper as easy as possible for people to understand. So that's my goal, you know. That's what made me want to get into business. The most difficult thing I endured in life. Well, one of the most difficult things I endured in life was growing up with no parents. You know what I mean? Everybody else had their parents. Everybody had a mom. Everybody had a dad. I was the only one without a dad, you know, or moms. And growing up, I was angry. I was always angry. So, you know, I used to get into a lot of fights, you know. I remember back in the days, you know, you say something about somebody's mama, that was like telling somebody SMD, you know what I'm saying? Your mama, what? My mama? So, you know, and I'm 5'6". I'm 5'6", so I was getting into a lot of fights. I was fighting big dudes, small dudes, everybody. You know what I'm saying? You know? Because, man, I ain't no chump, man. You ain't gonna play me. You know what I'm saying? For real, don't talk about my mama too. My mama dead, boy. Listen, but yeah, you know, that was one of the most difficult things I endured in my life growing up. And, you know, Mother's Day come around and I'm locked in the bathroom and everybody trying to get me out the bathroom and, you know, I'm crying and things like that growing up. It was hard, you know, but I enjoyed it, you know, and I'm here. You know what I'm saying? I'm here. That's just one of the major things that went on in my life, you know, so. One of the most difficult things I had to endure in the music industry. I think one of the most difficult things I endured in the music industry was learning how to apply and learning the things that I needed to learn. You know, everything else after that came easy. Once I opened up a book and went to school and I went to engineering school, you know, once I got all that and I experienced time came on and just applying it over the years, you know, I got why I am today. You know, so I think the most important thing, the most difficult thing I endured with the music was just taking the time out and finding the time to learn about things and how to apply it and, you know, being a business-minded individual and transferring, knowing when to put my street to the side and bring my business and have my business ethics and have my street credibility, you know what I mean? So it's kind of, you know, it's a two-page thing. You know, 1 minute I had to be the street dude in order to get my message across, and then because I'm independent and, you know, I do more the majority of work for myself, you know, I had to be able to learn how to take that hoodie off and be able to put that suit and tie on and stand up straight and shake a hand and you know, speak properly and not say and a lot, and you know what I'm saying. You know, it's a time and place for everything, you know, and I think, you know, when my mind knows exactly where I'm at, it plays that position. I don't have to think about it. It plays that position. So, you know, that's how I I want my music in movies, commercials, theater, jingles. You know, I want you to be able to go into Baskin Robbins and hear one of my, you know, slow jams or something in Baskin Robbins in the background. You know, things like that. I want my music. That's what I want to be able to do with my music. I don't just want to be a rap artist and mixtapes and albums and things like that, you know, so. I mean, it feels good to be getting my break. It's been years, man. I worked hard, you know, and then coming up and applying everything by myself, you know, all it takes is time. That's all I realized, is that all it takes is time. Time, learning, and experience. And then after a while, you just have the time to build and apply and put the bricks to your mansion and just steady build bricks. And then you start to see your work come to life and you start to see how big your portfolio is getting and how much work you put into and how your branding is working and things like that. So, you know, it feels good, you know, it feels good to be able to see people see me and try to put out professional work, you know what I mean? By myself, you know, so that's how I feel about that. What do I plan to do if I make it big? The first thing I plan to do is to, you know, take care of my family. One of my grandmothers, she's still living in the projects, man, in the city. You know, she's still living in the projects, and she's like 92, you know, and, you know, none of her kids were able to take her out of the projects. So, you know, if it's possible, that's the first thing I want to do. Her and my other grandmother, I'm just going to take care of my family first, you know, because that's one thing that I'm big on, and that's family, you know what I'm saying? So I'm working hard, and I'm trying to get my life together and get these things in order, put my priorities right. I mean, my life is together, I'm saying, like, you know, but get this music in order and make my business good, and I blow up, I get big. First thing I'm going to do is take care of my family and give them ways to start a business so they can, you know, have stability, and the next generation can have stability, and, you know, I'll start a generation of, you know, my family in good positions. So, you know, the next 3-4 generations, they'll be set, you know? So, that's one of the things I'm gonna do first. You know, I'm probably gonna be last, you know, my daughter's gonna be straight. That's guaranteed. She's definitely the first thing I'm gonna do is put some money away for her for school, you know, give her mama some money so they can move from where they live in. And, you know, just make lives better for a lot of people, not just my family, but, you know, other people. Because that's what I do now, you know? And I don't have millions, but I do it now. You know, I look out, I feed people, you know, I give people things. You know, it's nothing. These things are little. And because I'm able to be blessed with these type of things, I give back to people because, you know, I've been blessed and I believe, you know. So as long as he do for me, I'm going to do for others. And I hope that others will do for others, you know. And that's how we take care of our community. My education, well, growing up, I went to high school. I was very bad. You know, I didn't graduate high school when I got my GED, but after I got my GED, I went to school. I graduated from engineering school downtown on Spring Street in Manhattan, New York, the village. I graduated from engineering school, learning inputs, outputs, mixer boards, you know, things like that, routing, all that, making beats. And I was about maybe 13 back then when I graduated from there. Then I went to high school, didn't graduate, got my GED. Then I went to a community college. And when I went to the community college, I took up business administration the first time, import, export, things like that. And then the second time, I took up business administration, hotel technology. But, you know, due to the circumstances of my life, you know, I wasn't able to complete those. But, you know, the things that I did learn from the time being in school, you know, I apply now. You know, I apply in my life and, you know, it's just working for me. So, you know, as long as it works. Yeah, I'ma work it. look at mama, she be on it. Got me really want it. Look at mama, she be on it. Look at mama, she be on it. Soul Entertainment. Alright, well, Soul Entertainment, I don't really like, you know, talking about it because, you know, it's my company. So, you know, I had to differentiate the difference between, you know, being the artist, public relations, the founder of the company, the music artist, the marketer, the promoter, the website developer, you know, all those things, you know, is my company. I'm my own artist under my own label. So, you know, this Soul Entertainment's my company. You know, I love that thing, man. I built that thing from the bottom up. A lot of years of work. So the things that you're seeing now, some of it is like just piled up from old work from years ago. You know, a lot of my songs are old songs. I have one new song out that I put out this year, you know. So, you know, as time goes on, you'll see the progress. Everything you see, the art, the beats, the websites, everything. Everything you see with Soul Entertainment was created by me. But, you know, I'm trying to separate being an artist and being a founder of the company. So, you know, that's Soul Entertainment, you know, and I love this thing. Soul Entertainment, we're different. We're not the same. You know, we're past the atmosphere. We're past the stratosphere. We're out there with the stars. You know, we shoot for the stars. We do big things, you know. So when I joined the family, you know, I wanted to make sure that, you know, my family is going to be taken care of. My team is going to be taken care of. Anybody that joins Soul Entertainment, we're going to all be different. We're going to all be stars. We hang with the stars. We sitting on the moon. You know what I mean? We looking down. We're not the same. We up. We going up. That's all. Forward. You know? So that's all I'm saying. A typical day for me is, man, I do this all day. I wake up in the morning about 5:30, have my coffee, on the computer, check my accounts, check my pages, listen, watch the news, you know, and then I get to the music all day, whether it's the marketing, the promotion, the website, my artist, me as an artist, the music, making beats, fixing a page, adding stuff to a different page. It's always work to do, you know. I always got work to do, so, you know, I wake up 5:30 in the morning. And I work from 5:30 in the morning to about 1 o'clock the next morning. And then I'll maybe go to sleep like 2 o'clock in the morning sometimes. And then I'll wake right back up at 5:30 in the morning and do it again. Back to the marketing, back to the promotion, back to creating promo material, art, all that stuff. So, you know, a typical day for me every day out the week is all day music, business. You know, I have one kid, She lives 2 hours away. You know, I live by myself. I take care of my own responsibilities. So, you know, I have the time to really sit down, and what I've built is able to keep me sustained to where I can sit and really work on my craft and build myself and build my company. So, what skills are important to being successful? I think people skills. People skills and being honest with yourself. You know, I think that's the most important thing to being successful. You know, because it's about who you know. You know, and you know, it's about the person you are. You know, nobody just wants to always do business. Sometimes you gotta reach out and, hey, how are you today? You okay? I didn't want to call you on a business, and I just wanted to call you and say, hey, how you doing? And find out if you was alright and if there's anything I could do for you. You know what I mean? Those are the things that count. You know, it's not always about you as a person, you as an artist. It's about giving back to other people, letting other people be able to turn other people happy, open doors for other people. You know what I mean? I think that's what the key to having a successful career and being successful is about. You know, being successful and leading and leading positively, you know, and giving back and opening doors for people, you know, not building up your blessings for here, but building up your blessings for there, you know. So that's how I feel about that. School, you know, going to school, I would say for other artists, I would say go to school and, you know, take up a major that has to do with not just the entertainment, but the business end of the entertainment. You know, you got to know the business, you know, take up marketing, take up, you know, promotion, take up, you know, anything that has to do with the opposite end of the business, not just always music, but the other end of the business, because that's very important. Once you realize the business end of the music and the system, man, it's a system that, man, I'm telling you, it's a good system once you get into it and you start to realize how the gears work. It's like a car. You drive a car, you ain't gonna really care about the car if you don't really know about how the car ticks. But if you take the time and you looking in the engine and you checking under the car and you're in tune with your car, you're gonna see what makes the car ticks, what makes it easier for you to take care of the car and have the car for a numerous amount of years. It's the same concept. You know what I'm saying? When you care about it, you take it more serious. That's how I feel about that. What mistakes I think artists make in music? I think they're selfish. One, you know, they're always thinking about themselves. Come see me, check mine, check this, you know. I think that's one of the mistakes, you know. Another mistake I think that artists make is are spamming, you know, and not being able to find their marketing crowd. You know, you have to go out here and you can't just market to everybody. You can't just put your stuff in front of everybody's vision. You have to be able to you know, have the demographics of what target you're trying to reach, who you're trying to reach, who you're trying to let hear your music. You have to find a crowd of people that want your music and just feed to those type of people. You don't have to have everybody on your team, especially if you're indie. You just need a little bit of people and they're purchasing your things and you're good. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, that's how I feel about that. You know, that's where people make mistakes. How important is image? I think in the music industry, image is really important. You know, you got to give the people what they want. You know, would you come to Walmart if Walmart wasn't giving you what you want? You know, I don't think so. You know, would you go buy a car from someplace if they don't have the kind of car that you want? You know, so I think, you know, you have to give the people what they want. You're targeting, that's part of marketing. You have to give the market what they want. If you're an artist and you're putting out stuff and you want people to listen to your stuff and buy your stuff, whatever image, you know, you have to study the demographics and the stats. Whatever pictures with whatever you're wearing is getting the most likes and things like that. Those are the things that you have to focus on, you know. And you have to keep that image because it's all about what people want it to look like. Nobody wants a boring life. We don't have social sites, so we could talk about the things we're trying to escape, like problems, bills, relationships. Nobody wants that. We want to see the things that, you know, we want. The things that, you know, matter, like, that we're not getting. We want the happy things. We want to see diamonds. I want to see cars. I want to see somebody taking a trip. I want to see VIP floors. You know what I mean? Right. So, you know, you got to give the people what they want, period, you know? And I think that, you know, image is very important. And the type of image that you give off is the type of crowd that you're going to get back. So that's how did I achieve my career? Well, just a lot of planning, years of learning, and then years of applying, and now I'm just doing years of, you know, building. You know what I'm saying? It took years to learn about what I wanted to do. It took a couple years to apply what I wanted to do. And now I'm at the point where I can bring out what I've done. You know what I'm saying? So that's what I'm working on at the moment right now for that. Yeah, I have a couple last words. You know, first I just want to say thanks for tuning into this video, checking me out, and, you know, seeing what I'm about and things like that. You know, right now we got, you know, a lot going on with me. I'm working on my second mixtape, working on my first EP, working on a couple singles. So, you know, I just want everybody, if you got Spotify, go check me out on Spotify. If you got iTunes, Apple Music, go check me out on that. Whatever you got, just go add me, follow me, check my beats, check my company, and then check me out as an artist. Try to separate how you see me as an artist and my company, you know, so. Go check all that out. There's links. There's a whole bunch of stuff in my Instagram. Go add me on Instagram. Check my company's artists. Right now I'm doing a little bit of cross promotion for my company's artists. Go check out Riddles. I Won't. His new single is out. Go check my new single. I'm just working hard, trying to get everything situated and just give y'all good music, good image, and make people day brighter. You know, I want to say, stay focused. Don't let nobody tell you that your dream's not possible. Don't worry about other people if they're not putting no food on your table. Focus on you, your family, and your goals and where you're trying to be in life, because those are the things that matter, you know. So that's what I want to say. Just check me out, add me, check our website, and just, you know, if you like it, you feel us and you feel our message, just support. That's all I ask, is just support, you know. And the more y'all support, the more you're going to get, the more opportunities, the doors going to open. And, you know, I could come to your town and we shake hands, have a drink, whatever. I don't really drink too much, but, you know, I'm always working. So I want to say thanks. Well, thank you for having me. And, you know, get ready for 2018. All right. Yeah, thanks.